All right, here we go.
Action.
One of the things that was very important to us was that Lyle communicated without speaking. We were already dealing with a very lifelike character in this crocodile. The consequence of that choice made it so that he was soulful, that he was introspective, that he was sensitive, that he was a gentle giant from the very beginning.
We worked with an actor on the set who wore a rig and wore basically a version of Lyle's, you know, shape and size.
I got involved with the movie because my agent sent me an audition and she was like, you're weird and childish. Like, you would, I feel like you would do this well. Because I'm doing all the motion capture acting for Lyle, I have to wear this helmet, which has a sensor on the back that like knows where my head is pointed and in space at all times.
This like wire head cage represents the boundaries of Lyle's face so that when I'm talking to somebody, they don't lean in too close and like disappear inside my mouth.
And then there's this, we call it the girth suit. It's this like padded thing that is just the bane of my existence that is like strapped around me. And it just creates the boundaries of Lyle's body.
Well, we worked with a visual effects company called Method Allura in Australia. We started with the infancy of the character with them.
This film requires motion capture to make, with Lyle being a CG character. The tricky thing is, how do you make a human dance like a crocodile and also making it believable and not too cartoony?
We talked about him being photoreal, but also giving a little bit of characterization.
Josh and Will were very vocal about the fact that they wanted this to be an actor's environment. They didn't want this to be a technology environment.
The Lyle moves were firstly driven by the song, eventually. What could he do in each scene, in each environment? I wanted to use the environment more than just dance through the space.
It's amazing because you are, sometimes you are working with an actor dressed with many things on their face, and then you try to be organic with those things. But when they add Lyle, it's amazing. It makes everything falls into place.
Part of the face cage thing is that there's a camera mounted inside of it, like 8 inches from my face. It just captures and maps out every movement of my face.
Lyle's whole body is a completely different proportion than Ben's. We had to make fake eyes that are way up here where Lyle's eyes are, and it's very difficult for the actors not to look at the eyes of the person they're performing with. So we tried all different things, sunglasses, and we put LEDs in the fake eyes. It's just anything to say, look up here. So that's been a challenge throughout.
What an audience, and you performed.
So there were many limitations, and I wanted to use the crocodile movement to the best of their ability. Like, can he jump on his tail? Can he use it as a pogo stick? Can he swing, or can he use it as another appendage? What can he grab with the tail?
The tail's a tricky one because it has a mind of its own. I mean, it's like Lyle's fifth appendage, and it's 6 feet long. So there's many times in the film where it's gonna be doing things that I really don't have any control over. I'm just one of the multiple people that are coming together to create Lyle. And so there's me, and I'm responsible for all of the physical and like movement and emotional acting and the creating the relationships with the other characters. But then there's Luke, who's this wonderful young dancer who's doing all of the like really hard dance sequences that Lyle does. And then we've got Tom, who's doing some stunts, like when he wrestles with Mr. Prim and some other more dangerous things that Lyle does.
I couldn't even imagine doing it without Tom, who was in a black suit. And so, like, I really had somebody to wrestle with.
I mean, talk about real stunt work from, you know, Scoot. I mean, he really committed to it. We were like, do you need a stunt double? And Scoot was like, no, I'll do it myself. It was pretty amazing. And now, in the finished film, I don't think we could have done it if Scoot hadn't really committed like that.
Miles! Hey, buddy! Hey, are you okay?
In the crocodile enclosure, which is gorgeous, the set, they made this, like, little cave opening that I had to crawl out of, and they actually had me play other crocodiles as well. They were like, Ben, we need you to do this because you know how to walk like a crocodile. So I like had to play the mean crocodiles snapping at Javier.
No. Josh.
And I guess they were imagining just like a person crawling out of it, but like I have the girth suit on and I have this like helmet wire cage thing that gets snagged on everything. And I have to walk like a crocodile, so.
And that actor really brought a lot of the performance that we based the end result on, and that really helped us sort of jump the process of Lyle's performance forward.